Hi, I'm Dr. Srinivas Murthy TM, an ENT consultant practicing at Columbia Asia Referral Hospital Yeshwantpur and Srinivas Speciality ENT Center located at Yeshwantpur. Now, perforated eardrum. So what are the common causes for perforated eardrum? The commonest cause is a neglected cold. Now, other than this, the next commonest cause is a trauma to the ear. Now, when I say trauma, there are two types of trauma. One which is induced by the individual himself or herself. They use a foreign body like a Q-tip or a hairpin or some other sharp object in an attempt to clean the ear. And if they reach deep enough, they may injure the eardrum. This is a very rare occurrence. Nobody will willfully tear the eardrum and bear the pain. So it usually occurs accidentally, like they may be keeping something in the ear. Someone else who is passing very close by might touch their elbow, and hence the foreign body may go deeper inside and then cause an injury. Typically it happens when you are doing this in the presence of a toddler or an infant or a very young child who is playing around you, and then they may touch your elbow and then result in this injury. Hence, we recommend not to use any foreign body to clean the ear at any point of time, not just because you're going to injure. A majority of people don't require cleaning the ear. The ear has a natural cleansing mechanism. Now, the other thing is, in our Indian circumstance, we are very fond of slapping people across the face. Most of our comedy in movies is based on someone slapping somebody else across the cheek. Men in India take pride to slap their spouses or their girlfriends or their sisters. So we see an enormous number of women coming to us with a left-sided eardrum perforation following a slap. And that is because most men tend to be right-handed. This is purely a preventable problem. I think we as a society should move away from expressing our anger or our incapabilities through a slap. There are better modalities, and nobody in their right sense should slap anybody across the face. Now, what can go wrong when you slap somebody across the face? The palm can actually go and hit the ear like that, and there is an enormous buildup of air pressure in the ear canal, which has nowhere to release but across the eardrum, and hence the eardrum ruptures. Now, when that happens, we don't know to what extent that buildup of air pressure has actually damaged the inner ear. Fortunately, in a majority of people, no permanent damage occurs to the inner ear, and it is usually limited to a torn eardrum, a pain across the cheek, maybe a slap mark across the cheek, and a pain for a few days, tinnitus or noise in the ear of the victim for some days. When they come to us, few things that everybody needs to remember is never self-medicate with a ear drop. We don't want any liquid going into an ear with a perforated drum, especially a traumatic perforation. Don't allow water to get into your ear. Don't have a head bath before you meet your ENT doctor. And then we assess for hearing to see for any inner ear loss. If none of this is true, we just reassure the patient that give it time, and generally 95% of the people the eardrum closes on its own. Now this needs between 4 to 6 weeks time for it to have a spontaneous healing. If it doesn't heal beyond 6 weeks, then we recommend some surgical procedure whereby we can close the perforation so as to prevent further damage. Now, in a very rare occurrence, the eardrum may be torn to such an extent that the whole eardrum may be missing when we see. Now, in that case, what would have happened is the eardrum would have folded on itself into the middle ear. So, in such a situation, if we examine under the microscope, we will know that the eardrum has actually folded on to itself and has gone inside. In this situation, maybe we can actually take the patient into the operation theater under the microscope, try to avert back the folded eardrum, and then try to make it sit in close approximation to one another so that it heals better. Other than this condition, we wouldn't recommend surgery in the first go, Till date, I have not had an instance where I have had to take a patient into surgery on the first day that they have presented to me with a traumatic perforation.